Hi everyone, and welcome to Gwen Collects. So today's video was not supposed to go up this week. It was supposed to go up in a few weeks, but the video that was supposed to go up got kind of disturbed due to a broken figure arriving. It was a chill unboxing video, I was super excited about it, but one of the figures arrived broken. Very sad, but I wanted to do like a whole documentation of the process of getting the figure replaced. So I'm gonna keep the chill unboxing kind of on the back burner for now until I get the replacement figure and I can kind of talk about that, which I think will make actually a really good video. So it's okay that it came broken. We'll get a good video out of it anyway. So because of that video being derailed, I've had to reschedule a bunch of stuff for my January videos, and I decided that I would bump this video a little bit ahead, because it's one I'm really excited about. In this video, I will be 3D printing a base for my very first pop-up parade figure. A lot of people probably hate the pop-up parade bases, so when I saw that there was a file on my figure collection, which I will link down below, that allowed us to 3D print a base for this figure, I thought, perfect. I'll make a video out of it. So in this video, you'll see me document the whole process from unboxing the figure to 3D printing the base. I'll give my final thoughts at the end of the video, but there's already quite a bit of footage of me just doing the whole process. So I'm gonna stop talking for this introduction and I will pass the mic to past Gwen, who is unboxing the pop-up parade. So let's get right into this video. I'm really excited about it, so I hope you all enjoy. It's been a while since I did an unboxing in this style, but if I'm gonna be honest with you, I look like trash right now. So let's open up this package. It arrived today with absolutely no warning. Like, it was supposed to be tracked, but it just avoided every single scan until delivery. So yeah, this is a figure I have been waiting for absolute ages. And it is the focus of this week's video because the video that was supposed to come out this week, we had some issues, maybe a broken figure or something like that. So we're gonna have to wait on that video with some figures I was super excited to unbox, so that's disappointing. But this figure arrived to save this week's video, so I thought it would be fun to just do kind of like a quick video where I unbox my first pop-up parade, which is what is in this box, and also 3D print a cool base for it. So I feel like it's gonna be like a fun little video. I don't know, we'll see. But again, no X-Acto knife today. This is not the graceful unboxing I was hoping for. Okay. And the very first pop-up parade in my collection. The beautiful and wonderful, if the book says, Mako Makanchok? Makanchok? I never know how to say her name. Let me turn my ISO down. There we go. Now you can actually see her. Whoa. So the box isn't too big, which is good. I was worried it would be like massive, but it actually looks quite good. And she's super cute. Her paint job looks actually quite nice. I've always wanted a Mako scale, but I don't know if we're ever gonna get one. So I decided to go with her pop-up parade because I'm obsessed with the pose and everything. So I think I'm gonna be very pleased with this figure. Also, this was $37, I think. And I think shipping was like $9 maybe. from Good Smile US. That is why I'm getting it in January of 2022 and not August of 2021. Good Smile Company is, Good Smile US, I should say, is taking their sweet time with getting stock after Japan does. So if you have any orders with Good Smile US, just know you're probably looking at getting them about 5 to 6 months after Japanese release, which really sucks, especially because I'm so excited for Lufia and I ordered her from Good Smile US, but whatever, it's fine. We get these figures eventually. We wait ages for them anyway, so what's a little bit more of a wait? Also, I paid like $9 shipping for this, which I think is quite a good price, and obviously no like customs or anything. So I'm not too mad that I had to wait because she was a very good price. So anyway, let's open her up and start 3D printing this super sick base. I'm excited about this. So I personally quite like pop-up parade boxes. I think they're nice and simple. They show off the figure. I mean, it's good for a budget figure, right? We do get the clamshell packaging, which is better than a lot of prize figures, which I like. So inside the box, we have Mako looking adorable. And then we have her ugly, ugly colored base. Don't know why they chose this ugly ass yellow color, but they did. Not in love with that, but it's fine. Looks like there was a one piece of tape on the blister. Oh, there's a piece of tape on top though. Whoa. Oh, shoot. I will be right back. Just a little intermission. I was like, where's the red dye coming from? I cut myself opening this, so I'll be right back. Okay, everyone. We're back. We have the Band-Aid on. Let's finish up this unboxing. I was so confused there. I was like, what is all over my figure? Literally blood. Okay, so in the box we have the ugly pop-up parade base. This holds me back from buying so many pop-up parades because I absolutely hate the bases. Although in real life, this honestly looks better than pictures like online, but yeah, the base is like this ugly greeny yellow, literal urine color. But Mako herself looks fantastic. She's wrapped in like this little sleeping bag of plastic. Let's see. So I think her face, let's bring her up close to the camera, her face looks really, really nice. Her eyes are nice and glossy. She even has like some shading on her hair, like on her bangs. The hair has barely any like sculpting to it. It's pretty smooth. There is like a big seam across her head, but really nothing major. I do like that they made like the tips of her hair darker. And they do have a few lines sculpted. I mean, Mako has like a very bowl cut haircut. So I actually don't mind the really smooth look. I feel like that's pretty authentic for Mako. Her outfit looks great. There's not a ton of shading on it, but the paint is very clean. Cleaner than like some scales that I've gotten in the past. The shading on her skin looks great. She's got white panties on. The skirt has no shading from what I can see, but the amount of like lines sculpted into it give it definition, so I don't think the shading's really necessary. There is a bit of shading on her socks. They look good. They're painted onto her legs. It's not like a separate piece like some figures I have, and I think they look good. Since they're painted on her legs, kind of some of her skin shows through. It gives more of an actual sock look. And then we have her shoes, just plain brown shoes, and then the pegs come out the bottom, which will make her easier to put on our 3D printed base once we print it. But my camera does not want to focus on this figure. Come on. Come on. There we go. So yeah, I really, really like how she looks. I think they really nailed Mako in this. I'm pretty sure there's a garage kit that this is based on. But yeah, it looks super good. So I'm gonna put her on this base for now, just so we can have a look-see at her. But she fits onto the base very easily. She just pops right in. Wow, easier than a lot of my scale figures. So she's pretty big, actually. I'll have to do like a size comparison, but I mean, compared to like some of my 1/8 scales, she's probably like a small 1/8, like a 1/9 scale.
So not too bad at all. I think Papa Parades can be fairly inconsistent in their sizing, so I think she looks good. I'm excited to print her base and get her all set up. I'm very excited about this. I am quite impressed with my first Papa Parade. All right, here's the 3D printer. I might dub over this, so you might just see me moving and then audio Gwen is gonna talk. We'll see, because I feel like my camera audio is kind of trash, so we'll see. But here's my 3D printer. Looks very nice. I like it a lot. My dad got it for me for Christmas a couple of years ago, 2 years ago now. It is the, I have this light here to like help illuminate it. It is the Ender 3 3D printer. I am quite the novice when it comes to 3D printing, so please don't judge me too harshly. Okay. I can do my best, okay? I can do my best. Let's move this over to this side, actually. I am not the worst. I know, like, the basics. I already forget how to change the filament, though, so I'm gonna have to figure that out, because we need gold. Speaking of, where is the gold? I'm nervous to remove this silver. I'm gonna look up a YouTube tutorial, and then maybe, like, time-lapse me removing the filament and all that jazz, so. We'll keep recording after this, don't you worry. All right, got a YouTube video on, teaching me how to change it. It is turned on. All right, the silk gold has been freed. It looks very nice. And we're just gonna let the extruder heat up a little bit more. Just has to get to 200 degrees, so. With that, and then push the release, I think. Since we just squeeze that and pull the filament out, so. Let's hope that actually works. I'm gonna bring you guys in a little bit, I think, for this part. Okay. Let's hope this works. Frick, I'm like straddling the tripod right now. Boy. Success! Sorry if I like shook you guys. We have a big coil of this silver. Oh, whacked myself in the face. That is a-okay. Nice. Okay. Now for the actual hard part here, putting the gold in. This video is very helpful. It is how to change filament on the Creality Ender 3 by talking stuff. If engineering taught me anything, it's that the YouTubers in India know literally everything, so we just look to them for answers for literally anything, and they have the answers. So thank you, India, for making every university student's life easier. So, first, we take this beautiful gold filament that will be the base, and we, let's pop it the other way. Pop it on like so. I kind of want to clip off this like bent part, but I don't have clippers, so we're not going to do that. And we're just going to feed it in to the printer.
All right, hello everyone. Voiceover Gwen here to hijack this last clip. What you can see me doing right here is just rubbing a glue stick over the printing surface. Apparently this makes it easier to remove the prints. I don't know, my boyfriend told me to do it and he has more experience than me, so I took him at his word and I just did it. I'm also just prepping the print on the screen there. It's kind of hard to see the screen just because of my lighting situation, but yeah, I'm just getting the print ready. I also plug in like a micro SD card you'll see in a sec that has the Mako base print on it. Yeah, I know my base plate's dirty, but you know, I'm just too lazy to scrape off all the gunk. And to be honest, in past prints, I didn't think it really made that much of a difference how clean the base plate was. And sometimes it actually made it easier to get my prints off if the base plate was a little bit gunky. So I don't know. Experienced 3D printers are probably cringing right now, but it works just fine for me. So anyway,
I ended up actually failing a couple prints because the bed was not level. I think I jostled it around too much when I was loading up the filament, and it was not great. So this was the attempt that was actually successful-ish. So I'm pretty happy with how this print turned out. It took a lot of base leveling, but I think this print actually turned out really good. I'm pretty proud of myself for this one. I don't have a ton of experience, so I was pretty happy to have gotten it to work this well. So yeah, in the next clip, you'll see the final product.
I hope you enjoyed seeing the whole process from unboxing to 3D printing. Now I present to you the finished product. Well, not quite finished. I'll put some B-roll in of my print and the base and everything. It looks really, really great. I'm actually super happy with how it turned out. This was my first try. So there are a few things I'd like to fix in like future prints. So I'm definitely gonna give this a few more tries. But I'm honestly super happy with how it turned out. I think it looks amazing, way better than the Pop-Up Parade base. And I love that it's like Mako's brass knuckles. It's so cool. I'm super happy with it. So the main things I need to fix for next time are just these gaps that you can see with like the borders, especially in the star and then in some of the letters here. I noticed my 3D printer isn't making perfect circles, as you can see on the inside of the O. So I think I read online you need to like tighten the bands, like the, how do I describe that? Like the conveyor kind of bands around the where the motors run. So I'm gonna try tightening those to see if I can get better circles. But honestly, for a first attempt, I'm super, super happy with how this turned out. It just looks so good. My thoughts on the Pop-Up Parade are still the same as when I unboxed it. I think Mako looks fantastic. I love her so much. I think Good Smile Company really nailed it with her. To me, she's like a really, really nice prize. There's limited shading on a lot of areas, but they really, really killed it with like her face and her pose and even her size. She's a pretty great size. So yeah, I don't think she looks out of place in my collection that's mostly scales. I'll definitely consider picking up more Pop-Up Parades in the future after seeing how cute Mako is. Although I know the quality of them kind of is up and down. I think more on the down recently than the up, but I'm really happy with Mako, and I think the base just really like adds something to the figure. So if you have a 3D printer accessible to you and a Mako Pop-Up Parade, or really any Pop-Up Parade, I definitely recommend trying this out. I think it's a super fun idea, and a way to personalize your figures more, especially when Pop-Up Parades aren't super expensive, so you're not really risking anything making a base for them. I don't know, it's pretty fun. I've had a ton of fun kind of adding my personal touch to this. Thank you so much to Big Dingus Peepo on my figure collection for posting this awesome base. I actually reached out to them before this video just to like make sure it was okay that I like talked about their design. This is not my design, I want to make that very clear. I did not design this. Big Dingus Peepoo did on my figure collection. Wonderful username. So yeah, I did not design this, they did, but they said it was totally fine to put it in a video. So I would highly recommend giving this a try if you have a 3D printer available. I used an Ender 3, and to slice the print, I used Cura, which is a free software. The printer's obviously not free, but the software to slice it is free. So yeah, you just download the STL file, I'll link it down below. And then from there you can slice and print. I didn't show my settings because I just kind of did whatever. I did add some support material to it, but that's pretty much it. I'm not experienced enough for my settings to actually be meaningful to anyone. I'd recommend just playing around with it and seeing how your print goes. I'm excited to play around with this a bit more and see if I can improve the print at all. But I thought for this week's video, it'd be fun to just document this a little bit and bring you along for the journey. I hope you enjoyed Gwen Collects in the Garage. We've got a new setting for this week's video. But yeah, hopefully you enjoyed this more chill, kind of chaotic video. I hope to make more like this in the future. I really, really enjoyed making and editing this one. So yeah, I'm super, super excited about this. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Be excited for next week and the week after, because I have a massive December, Christmas, January haul coming your way. It's going to be a two-parter, one next week and one the week after. So I'm super excited. There's some figures in there that I'm just obsessed with. So anyway, super excited about the videos coming your way very, very soon. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you all next time. Bye!